mixed martial arts pioneer, Kyoshin Kosaka. TK for all of us boys back home. One of the first questions that Frank and I asked him was actually Frank that asked the question, but before we get to that, 27-19-2, stands 5'11", weighed 224 pounds, still in fantastic shape. The Frank Trigg asked him flat out, why? Why are you fighting? Why fight Mirko Krokop? He just looked us both in the eye, laughed, and said, because I'm still crazy.
Like, so you look at his record, you go back to 2006. His next fight's not until 2015. So he took all that time off and still had it, still wanted to come back in. Fought once in 15, once in 16, and then now will fight in 2017. He is a game individual, trains all the time, obviously he's here. Former Pancrase Super Heavyweight Champion, first man to defeat Fyodor Emelianenko, 8 wins by KO, 6 by submission. And if Mirko is lazy or sloppy or gets an ability where he has a brain fart, TK will grab a submission, will be able to finish it on him. And this is one of those things where that's what Mirko was talking about. I've got to be careful. He's an extremely well-rounded individual, extremely well-rounded mixed martial artist, and an amazing coach for the next generation of kids that he loves to coach. So as a result, you got to think about what's going to happen with TK once he steps inside that ring. It could be dangerous for Mirko if he doesn't pay attention.
He says perfect fight versus Mirko Krokop is to put lots of pressure on him, close the space, do not under any circumstances give Mirko space. Speaking of kids, shout out to his daughter, 12-year-old, who loves cheerleading, and his son, a boy obviously, 8 years old, loves wrestling. Now, for the mixed martial arts community around the world, we're about to get all nostalgic. Frank and I will not say a word as Mirko Krokop and Wild Boys come down to this.
赤コーナーよりミルコ・クロコップ選手の入場です。181cm 101.7kg 高坂剛。赤コーナー 188cm 110.15kg ミルコクロコップ レフェリー ジェイソン・ハーゾク
There are certain sacred moments when it comes to mixed martial arts, Frank Trigg, and that moment there not only gave me goosebumps, I had goosebumps on my shins, my thighs, my back. Mirko Krokop and Wild Boys, when he walks down to the ring, is just something special. And one that you also love, ironically or coincidentally, is when Vanderlei Silva makes his way and we hear Sandstorm. Moving forward, if we get to call Sandstorm with Vanderlei Silva, we're not talking.
And I completely agree with that.
Judge.
Here we go. Mirko Krokop. TK. TK said he cannot give Krokop space. Krokop says, I'm just going to push this guy around and make him pay.
Uh-oh. Krokop got hit.
Punishing punches by Krokop. Look at his
side. Oh, that's it. Oh.
Krokop landing four. Sorry, right hands after right hand. Now has TK on the ground. Look for the vicious ground of how to commence.
TK doing a good job of moving underneath. Trying to tie one of his arms.
My goodness. Krokop just launching the power bombs here.
TK's got his arm caught. His left arm is caught underneath. He's got to get out of here. He's got to push himself away.
Oh, there's the left. Mirko Natural, left-handed fighter. TK's bloodied up. He's all caught up. Getting punished from your referee. He's making a look. He threw in the towel and said, that's it. It's over. Krokop, once again, emerges victorious here in Japan with some ruthless power, Frank Trigg.
Wow, that was... Jeez. Now we got to worry about... Krokop's going to have to pass the torch to Usawa Gomi.
Well, I don't know about that because he said, he told us flat out, if I could have a retirement fight, it would be against Fedor Emelianenko. Unfortunately for Fedor Emelianenko's career, it hasn't been going the way Krokop thinks it would be big enough in Japan. I still think it's big enough to take place. I understand Fedor's career has taken a bit of a dive, but that's a classic fight that we would all love to see. But Mirko said, if that is not going to work, then what I do want to do, like you said, is I want to take on the next young buck that Ryzen can build. In my retirement fight, I just want to go out on my sword. I do not want to fight and defeat a tomato can in my final fight. I want to fight, I would rather lose an exciting fight than win versus a tomato can.
And he says he's more likely going to fight twice next year. So we're looking at sometime, you know, probably July, and then again, December 31st, the big New Year's Eve show next year. That'll be his final swan song. And we obviously saw, you know, so 205-pounders fight on the 29th.
Albertson for Huska.
Yeah, and yeah, that's a great fight. Either one of those guys would be a great matchup. And there's his good friend and manager, Ken Amada, right there in front. It is a storied career, and it's just tough to figure out, like, because you want Krokop to go out on a good note, but he also wants to be challenged. He does not want to walk away without being completely challenged. And it's very difficult. Of course, there's still a lot of heat between him and Vanderlei Silva. Like there's been heat. They still don't particularly like each other. You know, he said to us, like, Vanderlei's a very weird cat. Sometimes he says hi, sometimes he doesn't.
The gentleman right behind Mirko Krokop right now, over his right shoulder, his name is Ante Delia. That was the man that I was hinting at on the 29th show as to who potentially Prochaska can fight next if Ryzen is willing to put that fight on. Mirko told us this. This guy is the future. Ante Delia is an absolute monster when it comes to ground and pound. You guys have no idea. And he kept saying, Joe Frank, you watch. Yeah. Watch. If he signs with Ryzen, you will see the future of heavyweight mixed martial arts.
So I want to explain something to you guys. So that the Asian gentleman in the back in the sport coat in Mirko's corner, that's Ken Amada. He's been his manager for life. Like they're very close friends. They, you know, the kids hang out together. They own property together. They have other businesses together. Ken was retired. He was out. And then all of a sudden, Ryzen wanted Mirko to come back here and fight. Ken all of a sudden has come out of retirement because Mirko will not deal with anybody else but Ken. I asked Ken, what are you going to do now when Mirko retires in a year from now? What are you going to do? He goes, the only way I would stay in the game is if Mirko asked me to help with his teammate. And that's the only way Ken's going to stay in it. And it's just a huge deal for these type of guys that are, I'm out, I've retired, man. I've had enough of this whole game.
見事な一瞬の決着でした。ミルコ・クロコップ選手です。おめでとうございます。
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
ありがとうございます。
ここまで日本人には負けなし、そういった記録が続いていました。そんな中での今日の一戦、どんな準備をしてミルコさんリングに上がったんでしょうか。
Prvo pozdrav svim gledateljima. Go Hajra Nove TV i svi koji su nam pratili u Hrvatskoj.
クロアチアのですね、みんなも見てくれてると思って、まあ、自分の全てを出し切ろうと思いました。
ミルコさんにとって K1 時代、プライド時代、そしてこのライズインと、この日本のリングというのはどういった存在なんでしょうか。
Well, fighting in Japan is a special feeling for me, and especially I'm one of the last of my generation from Pride, but I'm still standing. I'm still standing, and I still compete on a high level. And I want to thank Mr. Koshaka too for accepting this fight. And I hope he will be okay. Hope he isn't injured. Something more serious.
そうですね、やっぱり日本の土地っていうのは自分にとって特別な場所であります、おっしゃっていただいたように、まあ、自分のこれまでの戦績、思い出がある場所であります、そして、まあ、言ってみれば自分の世代の、まあ、最後の一人、だと思うんですね。ただ、まあ、今日皆さん見ていただけたでしょうか。十分な力をまだまだ持っているということ、これからも見せていきたいと思います。それから、まあ、対戦を受けてくれた、まあ、小坂剛選手ですね、本当にありがとうございますと伝えたいですね、ぜひすぐ良くなっていただきたいですね。
ミルコさんは来年、まあ、引退をするという宣言をされていますが、あとどれぐらい我々の前で試合をしてくれるんでしょうか。
Well, definitely. The last fight you will see from me will be on 31st December in 2018. That's my final decision. And at the end of the day, I really would like to fight 10 or 20 more years, but there needs to come end to everything. But I had a big and rich and successful career, and definitely I will fight at least one more time before that December to keep my body in shape. And After that, 31st December, and it will be it.
まあ、確かに、すでに表明した通り、来年の12月31日、まあ、大晦日をですね、最後の試合の日にしたいと、まあ、それまでに、まあ、少なくても1回はですね、まあ、体の、まあ、調子をしっかりと整えて維持していくために、皆さんに試合を見せられたらいいなと思っています。まあ、10年20年とずっとこうして戦ってきて、いい結果をここまで残せたことを幸せに思い、最後まで走り抜けたいと思います。
ありがとうございました。見事な勝利でした。ミルコ・クロコップ選手でした。
Well, there you have it. Mirko Krokop once again emerges victorious in Japan. An absolute drubbing, a leather pounding. A fellow mixed martial arts pioneer, TK Choki Kusaka. An amazing job though. Just fantastic. Fantastic by Mirko. You just got to think to yourself, TK's brave. To take on Mirko Krokop, but especially at this age. But Mirko's still looking fantastic. He won the tournament last year. Just looked absolutely incredible then. I know he took up Baruto in the first round and then Ayakbari in the finale. He's just got that power. He's just got that strength. And then tonight, I mean, the fight was shorter than the walkout.
Yeah, it really was. We heard Wild Boy a lot longer than the actual saw Mirko fight. So the one thing I do want to mention is that it really makes me happy when a legend of the sport, a guy that I looked up to, within the sport, a guy that I wanted.